Families of Solutions, Level 2. In this video, we're going to verify general solutions, also known as an n-parameter family of solutions of differential equations. Let's go ahead and try the first example. Verify that the indicated family of functions is a solution of the given differential equation. The differential equation is the derivative of p with respect to t equals p times the quantity 1 minus p. And the one parameter family of solutions to verify is p equals c times e to the power of t over the quantity 1 plus c times e to the power of t. Notice that this family of solutions contains one parameter. Although it may seem like it contains two parameters, one in the numerator and one in the denominator, the same constant appears in both numerator and denominator, so we are actually dealing with one parameter. It just happens to appear on both numerator and denominator. On the other hand, if this family of solutions were to contain two distinct parameters, then we would be dealing with a two-parameter family of solutions. Alright, similar to the way we verified particular solutions in the previous videos, let's first find the derivative of this one-parameter family of solutions. In order to find the derivative of p with respect to time, we're going to have to use the quotient rule. Applying the quotient rule, we obtain the following expression. Next, let's go ahead and simplify the numerator by distributing the c times e to the power of t term, and then collecting like terms. Doing that, we obtain the following expression for the derivative. Having found the derivative, it's just a matter of substituting this expression into the differential equation, making sure that the left and right-hand side of the differential equation match. Substituting the derivative along with the solution, we obtain the following expression. Distributing the expression on the right-hand side of the equation, we obtain the following. Next, we need to find a common denominator and modify the numerators accordingly. Then, it's just a matter of simplifying the numerator and collecting like terms. In the end, we see that both sides are equal to each other, meaning that this one-parameter family of solutions is indeed a solution to the differential equation. The process of verifying family of solutions is essentially identical to that of particular solutions. The only difference is that we need to take into consideration the parameter c. Notice that the interval of definition for this one-parameter family of solutions depends on the value of the parameter c. In a later video, we will deal with problems that actually requires us to find a value for this parameter. For now, all that is required from us is to verify this general solution. Alright, let's try the next example. The differential equation is the second derivative of y with respect to x minus 4 times the derivative of y with respect to x plus 4y equals 0. And the two-parameter family of solution to verify is y equals c sub 1 times e to the power of 2x plus c sub 2 times x times e to the power of 2x. Notice that this family of solutions contains two parameters, c sub 1 and c sub 2. This means that this family of solutions is a general solution of a second-order differential equation. Alright, let's go ahead and find the first and second derivative of this general solution. Let's first find the first derivative. Applying the chain rule, along with the product rule, we obtain the following expression. Next, let's go ahead and simplify the expression so that we can find the second derivative. Applying the chain rule, along with the product rule, we obtain the following expression. Then, we go ahead and simplify the expression by collecting like terms. Having found the first and second derivative, we proceed by substituting these expressions into the differential equation. This way, we can verify that the left and right-hand side of the equation are equal to each other. Substituting the expressions, we obtain the following. Next, let's go ahead and distribute the constants. From here, it's just a matter of simplifying the expressions by collecting like terms. The term containing the constant c sub 1 reduces to 0. The terms containing the constant c sub 2 times x also cancels out. the term containing the constant c sub 2 and the exponential function also cancel out, leaving us with the final expression 0 equals 0. Hence, this two-parameter family of solutions is indeed a general solution to the second order ODE. Alright, let's try the final example. The differential equation is x cubed times y triple prime plus 2x squared times y double prime minus x times y prime plus y equals 12x squared. And the three-parameter family of solutions to verify is y equals c sub 1 over x plus c sub 2 times x plus c sub 3 times x times the natural log of x plus 4x squared. Notice that this general solution contains three parameters, c sub 1, c sub 2, and c sub 3. This three-parameter family of solutions is a general solution of the third-order ODE. Alright, since we are dealing with a third-order ODE, we're going to need the first, second, and third derivative of this three-parameter family of solutions. Before we start, let's rewrite the first term of this function into a derivative-friendly form. Specifically, c sub 1 times x raised to the power of negative 1. Now let's go ahead and take the derivative term by term, applying the power rule and product rule when necessary. Simplifying the expression, we obtain the following for the first derivative. Next, let's proceed with finding the second derivative. We once again take the derivative term by term and applying the power rule and taking the derivative of the natural logarithm. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Lastly, we need to once again find the derivative, so we proceed by finding the derivative term by term and applying the power rule. This results in the following expression for the third derivative. Now it's just a matter of substituting these derivatives into the differential equation and verifying that both the left and right hand side match. Substituting the expressions, we obtain the following. Next, let's go ahead and distribute the following terms. From here, it's just a matter of collecting like terms and simplifying the expression. The terms containing the parameter c sub 1 add up and cancel each other out. The terms containing the parameter c sub 3 also cancel each other out. The terms containing the parameter c sub 2 are also eliminated. And finally, the terms containing the parameter c sub 3 along with x and the natural logarithm also cancel out. This simplifies to 12x squared, which matches the right-hand side of the equation. Hence, this three-parameter family of solutions satisfies the differential equation. Verifying family of solutions is similar, if not identical, to the way in which we verified particular solutions. The only difference is that these solutions contain parameters. Alright, in our next video, we will start verifying implicit family of solutions as well as verifying a piecewise defined solution.